A delegation traveling to Hong Kong is made up of some very important guests. They will receive the highest standards of treatment, and security will be tight.
兴奋，非常非常兴奋。
The trip is taking place in late May 2022. Because of their special identities, instead of traveling together, the guests will be divided into separate groups for their journey from Beijing's Palace Museum to their destination in Hong Kong's West Kowloon Cultural District. Here, the distinguished guests will stay for over a month, some for three or even longer. Their accommodation has been created specially so that each of the thousands of visitors they receive will have the best possible chance of bonding with them.
Okay.
On December the 10th, 2021, the entire staff of the Hong Kong Palace Museum are moving into their new office, with less than 200 days left to go before the museum officially opens. They have a long checklist of tasks to complete beforehand. Everyone is under pressure. The team are curating a world-class exhibition. To accomplish the task, international experts have been brought in.
我是做宫廷织绣方面研究的一个学者。 大部分的工作时间是在美国，各个博物馆来从事这个中国艺术的研究和推广。他们是全世界来招聘这个博物馆的副馆长，因为这个博物馆的副馆长，他们需要不仅是懂中国文化，还要跟故宫有非常好的这个合作伙伴关系。
故宫比如说好看的，其实万紫千红那个展的是非常好看的。这句话还可以是我们自己说的，因为我今天跟故宫说的，我们又这个也是被说话。哎，我叫焦天龙。
我现在是在故宫担任他们首席研究员。我最重要的就是展览研究，作为我们这个所有策展人的这个领班和展览的好坏，研究水平的高低，还有未来的收藏，是什么样的，我要负很大责任。设计部是密切合作，设计部是要按照策展人研究员的思路来把它变成视觉化，就是 visualize。
And the themes of the exhibition is also very similar to ours, which is the making of
natural. I'm concerned, about whether we should put here, this one here. Mm-hmm. Is this okay, but then put the visitor logo here?
The idea behind it is to give a very fresh feel to the project.
No, I think the problem is the combination of the two languages, because you can only flip the book in one direction.
The book is like good to the language.
Shall we stick to the concept, having a beautiful detail, but make it more striking, more dynamic?
我们这个团队非常的国际化。
可以说是这个把最优秀的人才都到我们这里来了吧。
Jesse, we have a surprise for you. You passed your probation period with flying colors. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So excited to join.
Today, Liang Jiafeng from the US's Getty Conservation Institute is officially joining the Cultural Relics Repair Department. Individuals like her, who are professional experts in Chinese artifacts and art history, have been joining the staff of the Hong Kong Palace Museum from all around the world. These young professionals have studied under some of the most renowned experts in the world. They have been brought together in Hong Kong to set up and run the museum.
How do we make our past 5 years a very good conservation plan?实现把故宫的文物很好的陈列出来，把我们这个教育活动提供给观众，得到我们开馆这个目的，这个广，这个视野，一个使命，怎么样去推动中国文化，促进世界文明的对话。
这个项目呢，说起来这是5年多的时间，但是实际上真的是弹指一挥间，啊，太快了。那么我们常规筹备一个大型的文物展览大概都需要2-3年以上的时间，更何况这么一个整个的这么一个馆啊，从无到有，同时我们有开馆展览就有7个展览同时展出，规模这么大，规格这么高，我们说充分体会了时间紧任务重的这个难处啊，同时呢又因为这几年叠加了新冠疫情，给这个工作呢造成了很多的不确定性啊，所以确实这个难度非常大啊，真是甘苦自知吧。
你从2017年开始向这个正式公布这个项目，到2021年，很多博物馆它可能能把馆舍建好，但是呢，它可能不会开幕有9个展览，而且9个展览里面基本上没有太多是自己藏品，这个事情其实是不太可能的。
Preparing for the arrival of the artifacts from Beijing while planning 9 exhibitions. Innovation has been their goal as well as their starting point. What challenges will they face over the next 4,000 plus hours? Will the Hong Kong Palace Museum be able to open on schedule? The very first task assigned to the team is to tell the story of a site at the very center of Chinese cultural history, the Forbidden City, in a way that is both interesting and also succeeds in conveying its importance. Relaying between Beijing and Hong Kong, curators from both museums entered into an intense joint effort to select artifacts and plan exhibitions in 2018.
同时呢实际上是我们希望故宫的专家学者们对这么多的文物的价值的阐释能够通过这些一系列的一个整体的一个展陈在那个地方呈现出来。我们这次都是系列的，一共9个展厅，其中7个展厅是留给故宫的主题文物展。我觉得从长远来讲是一个文化文明对话的一个平台，文化交流的平台。
那么我们业务部门的这些专家学者们啊，他们花费了大量的心血，从几年以来啊，跟香港的团队一起，夜以继日吧，可以说啊，磨合这个展览大纲啊，首先确定主题，磨合大纲，遴选展品啊，这个保养文物等等等等的这些工作啊，还有我们要撰写图录啊，有一个专业的这种学术成果呈现给大家。
我希望有一个展览是整体要把整个故宫的建筑、故宫的产品来源，然后从它的历史、故宫它这个皇朝跟中西文化交流，然后故宫博物馆的成立，给观众一个代感。
第一个叫紫金万象这样的展览，它就通过建筑典藏和文化传承，让你来了解 我们中国人在这个空间建筑上来体现的我们哲学精神啊，它的典藏，它每件器物里蕴含的有些这种礼制啊，儒家思想啊，还有一代代的文脉的传承，就是你有一个中国文化的总体的印象。
The emperors of Ming and Qing dynasties wanted their biggest palace to overwhelm visitors. An aim of Gallery One is to convey a sense of this. The Forbidden City is indeed the largest palace in the world, made up of more than 8,000 individual buildings. The challenge is to present its incredible scale in an exhibition space of 880 square meters.
第一展厅我觉得还是不错的，就是用一种几个章节的形式，本馆的这个开幕展的一个宏观介绍。
第一部分是紫禁城建筑，虽然这个展区的文物不是很多，但是这个展区很有意思，就是您一进来就可以看到跟我们紫禁城相关的一些文物，比如说它有一个独立的空间，是明间宝座间的那么一个那个设计，然后我们古建筑明间的一个这个陈设，它就是有宝座屏风，然后还有香筒，还有仙鹤，然后把它摆放在那里，就让人好像是置身到我们故宫那个原状的那么一个环境里头。
Gallery One 比较好玩的东西应该是赵广超老师设计的多媒体地图，因为紫禁城嘛，它是从元大都时期就已经有个地基的元大都的基础上，然后再重新建造改建的，让大家看一看紫禁城它历年来这六百多年来是经历了什么样的变动。那第二个单元呢，是要讲紫禁城的宫廷里面的生活一些仪式啊，然后那第三个单元呢是讲紫禁城里面的这些物品，他们当初是如何被使用的，他们是如何被收藏，然后清代的时候有哪些新的技术，创造了哪些新的工艺。那第四个单元是看清代的紫禁城跟其他世界上其他地区是如何交流的。那最后一个单元呢，其实是在讲紫禁城如何从一个皇城转变成如今的博物馆。
From 500 years of court life in the Ming and Qing dynasties, the curators from Beijing and Hong Kong have carefully chosen over 1,000 items to introduce visitors to the life of the royal family and art and culture of the palace.
你这边安一个。你进来的时候按一个有一点点声音，
能
到画面里面。
点上的时候按一个到两个行，
可以吗？小一点的 speaker。
第二个展览是关于紫禁城一个生活的展览，是这个 EO 他就把一个不如我们找一个过去一个皇帝一天一个生活，早上到晚上出来。
当然，我们整个展厅的文物有300多件，是整体的所有的我们故宫的开幕展里面文物数量最多的一个展厅。我们表现的形式主要是坤宁宫的这个朝祭，就是早上的时候啊祭祀的这个场景啊。世界各地的观众都是想知道这个皇帝皇后啊，这个帝后还有这个宫里的人每天干什么呀，他是非常想知道的，他有好奇心 啊。我们这主要是体现了一个乾隆他对诗歌的这个热爱，再一个呢就是一个场景，10点钟的时候呢，乾隆在这边呢和他的慈臣啊一起来做这个茶宴的一个情景。
Then they have to blow this up quite a bit
That you cannot cover, the rest you can cover, potentially.
到时候它是个 video, 是个 video, 现在只是测试这个图像，因为我们上面很多 tracks, 看我们怎么样去处理这个 tracks 的影响。
So you're not going to come too close to it.、Mm-hmm. And this, optically, it's set up for about this distance.
So I'm Jeffrey Shaw. I've been an artist all my life. What was proposed to me was the curators here would like to have an experience that was the equivalent of his dream.
So that's one problem, and the other problem is the fact that my view is blocked.
So we designed a circular couch where 12 people can lie down in a circle and look up at this.Quite big screen, it's about 5 meters in diameter. So you see portraits of the emperor and his wife. You also see certain, you know, sort of significant creatures like the dragon and the phoenix. You see two butterflies which are flying together. So these are the very classic important symbols.
依舊橫陳, 欲怎辨?
Also, you hear the poem. There are small speakers speaking one specific poem that he wrote to her.
就是我们希望是通过一些那个沉浸式的场景体验，让观众可以近距离的感受清代宫廷生活的细节。以讲故事的方式呢，让观众更多的去体会拉近他和这个清宫历史啊、人物啊，还有物品的这个距离，这个是非常重要的。
Within this space, artifacts from the Forbidden City in Beijing, multimedia visual design, animation special effects, installations, and sound design create a three-dimensional experience visitors can walk into. Once there, they witness court life in China more than two centuries ago. With the 21st century well underway, museums around the world are embracing more innovative forms of expression.
So today,进入了一个全球化的时代。我们走向中华民族伟大复兴的这样一个历史进程之中，我们怎么从历史中汲取教训，面向未来？这是故宫带给我们，我觉得非常重要的启示。作为这个第一批的这些博物馆的创业者，给
Through immersive and interactive experiences, the reinterpretation and dialogue of contemporary art are another goal of the Hong Kong Palace Museum.
居士展厅主要展出的是清代宫廷肖像的一个专题展。这个展厅最大的一个特点就是它的文物少，我们是建了三面，很宽的宽银幕的投影屏，重建当时寿皇殿祭祀这些肖像的场景，来让大家身临其境的去感受到这些肖像在清代原来的那个功能。Is
it possible that this projector behaves differently to that projector?
I don't think so. I think
no, the same.
Yeah, see what happens. This is 25 frames per second.
Yes.
当时我们为什么会找艺术家 Jeffrey Shaw 是因为他有这方面的经验，他也曾经做过复制周礼的一个视频，所以我们就邀请了他参加我们这个寿皇殿的复原。Every
dynasty in Chinese history has seen the creation of outstanding horse-themed art, whether depicting horseback acrobatics, mounted archers, riding musicians, or a royal hunting party. Such works never cease to charm and inspire. In addition to 79 artifacts from the Palace Museum and 13 from the Louvre in Paris, Gallery 9 also contains multimedia installations. At the end of 2021, Jeffrey Shaw visits a racecourse in Luowu, Hong Kong, to observe and study horses in preparation for one of his installations.
Now you're starting today. Then today you can learn, yeah. I think the one way to communicate is to do the bites.
I think what the step we can make now is actually modeling those courses.
Yes.
As they go through Gallery 9, I hope they really will think about deeply the relationship between human and symbol, which is the horse.
In the collection of the Palace Museum, there are these sculptures of mythological horses, also one very beautiful painting. But I'm going to bring these to life as animations.
So in the mythology section, the installation is based on the idea of Tian Ma Xing Kong. We try to make full use of the height of our gallery because the horse gallery is the gallery with the highest ceiling in our museum.
So today we're just testing the projectors. And we also have the computer here for the first time. So we're going to install the application and just see it running. And then the question was, well, how to indeed bring this to life.
The horse is like this on an angle facing you, okay? And then it just simply goes like this, and then goes like that.
I needed to do was to bring these horses to a bigger scale. In other words, to bring them back to their life size. So the final horse is 1-to-1 scale horse. Yeah. This is a very big work. It's about 10 meters wide, 5.5 meters tall. It's using a special technology called lenticular printing. And this gives this very particular three-dimensional effect. But at the same time, I've created an installation where there are sensors which can detect the presence of viewers, of visitors, which means we have a painting which is brought to life and a painting which also is aware of the visitor's presence so that the horses actually react to the visitor's presence.
Should traditions remain as they have been historically, or should they be changed and updated? Gallery 5 presents a dialogue between contemporary design and traditional techniques. In this space, visitors see some of the finest designs from ancient China, from thousand-year-old bronzes to more recent masterpieces resulting from a fusion between Eastern and Western art. As the world moves on, what parts of a culture remain the same? The artist Stanley Wong has recorded the traditional techniques of local designers and artisans at work in Hong Kong, echoing the masters who created the national treasures from Beijing. His purpose is to tell visitors how Chinese craftsmanship has stood the test of time. Contemporary works on show include a red, white and blue series of nylon vases created in celebration of the Hong Kong spirit. Also on display, another piece of the same colors looks like it could have been made in the 21st century too. But in fact, it's from the reign of Emperor Chenlong of the Qing dynasty. In less than a month, this exquisite work of art will be displayed in the glass showcase that is being tested now.
要向橫體，亦都要向前向後體，所以應該係咁。我想問，如果我哋呢個，如果大家應該覺得個防線嗰個感覺係接受嘅，係咪將會呢個都係呢個色，都係物料，呢個都係呢個物料？我頭先要克服好多問題，因為我哋嘅設計係有方嘅，方又包括正方、長方、有高有低，但係我哋刻意地、著意地加咗啲係圓。策展團隊喺選材咩嘢嘅文物能夠代表到宮廷生活、北京故宮嘅收藏嘅精神境界高度，選咗之後，其實只係呢個故事嘅起點，工藝帶到嚟今天，仲存唔存在？
將會見到嘅就係四個香港人嘅設計師，透過呢四個工匠，透過呢四個設計師，就好快將個距離即刻拉到今天。雖然我哋用咗四個代表嘅人物去介紹呢四個個案，但係佢唔係得呢四個，其實呢四個代表咗呢一班人。 呢個系統其實佢哋堅持緊中國文化。
The success of this exhibition hall will promote comprehensive exchanges between the two palace museums, exchanges in educational activities, exhibition design, and new media. It should also provide inspiration and a valuable reference source for today's design industry. In Gallery 7, six Hong Kong multimedia artists will offer interpretations of Palace Museum culture. Celebration will be an audio installation inspired by court music instruments exhibited in the museum. Strokes of Tide will pay homage to masterpieces of calligraphy exhibited in Gallery 8. Timepieces of Destiny will be inspired by antique clocks collected in the palace. Seeing infinity in objects will reflect on theories behind Chinese painting and the idea of seeing the small through the great. Stars over vast wilderness will explore the ancient Chinese view of the heavens, as well as the long history of the Forbidden City. Objectified will seek to enhance viewers' perception of cultural relics by removing the objects from their historical context.
我哋都希望我哋香港能夠好似做一個橋梁咁樣，去幫呢啲香港呢一代嘅即係創意人才咧，去揾多啲機會啊，去有多啲空間去表現自己咁樣。故宮無界、故宮文化再傳承咧，係今次我哋七號展館嘅一個主題。
喂，而家想睇一睇你嗰個咩情況進度？所以呢個其實又唔係純粹一個裝置，其實係一個
media，係啊，你行緊嗰陣時，佢本身我哋話齋，佢真係需要嗰陣時，係啊係啊。
其實是館長他提出的，要不要我們邀請香港藝術家用他們來說故宮的故事？這個其實很好的一個角度。係，
大部分嘅佢睇唔到嘅，其實佢只係睇到光嗰一束光經過嘅地方，或者反到嘅地方咧，見到嗰啲 object。
文化意思係咩咧？佢只得到外形，佢冇其他嘅嘢。
佢已經冇咗表面嘅一啲嘅痕跡，咁對於你嚟講又係一啲咩意思咧？當然，我們這個是一個新的節，嗯，是一個，是一個，是一個，其實佢係建立咗一個好大嘅一個空間啦。
讓朋友可以入到去咧，去聽一啲唔同嘅聲音嘅。
好好玩喎！
真係個玻璃㗎，所以初頭好擔心，好擔心嗰個紅色會唔會太過長。
唔會好好。
但係聽到喺個環境度係好靚嘅。
咁
好多時咧，佢以聲音作為一個主要嘅媒介咧，佢希望將呢一樣嘢咧係可以轉成一啲唔同嘅可能性啦，讓大家唔係淨係以一個耳仔去聽，而係佢能夠全身咁去感受聲音帶嚟嘅一啲嘅可能性。 雖然係一個當代藝術創作啦，但係我好希望佢哋嚟睇嘅時候咧，佢哋係唔會覺得係有違和嘅。希望佢可以融和啦，希望佢可以互補啦，希望佢哋覺得呢一個係一個整體啦。呢樣嘢係我覺得最緊要嘅。
Although these installations are guided by contemporary ideas and incorporate the latest technology, they are also in harmony with the aesthetics and spirit of the Forbidden City. What kind of treasures are worth preserving to be inherited by the entire human race? From over 1.8 million pieces of the Forbidden City's collection, 914 precious artifacts were selected for display at the opening exhibitions of the Hong Kong Palace Museum. Among them, 166 are first-class cultural relics with national treasure level status.
因为这个本身这这么大一片磬啊，磨这么好，还挺难得的，所以它这上面这个那个这个漆补漆的这部分就我还挺关注的。如果他们这边修完了，我们4月18号就集中的时候就预装箱了。Guaranteeing
that all items arrive in Hong Kong safely and well protected is the top priority. Everyone knows this is a mission where they cannot afford to fail.
一步一步的走过来，那么在这过程当中，说实话，我们也非常的感动啊，就是这个项目从开始到现在，由内到外，由上到下，所有的单位。 啊，所有的部门，所有的同事啊，我们和我们所有的合作伙伴，大家真的是这样，把这个项目放到看得非常重。
这个博物馆可以说很多的方面都是史无前例，它故宫从来没有这么多文物一次，而且这么等级这么高的文物一次的这个出故宫。
一级文物有166件，从来没有。不单是一级文物，有些文物是无价的，一些古代书画这个价钱是天价的，所以我们还需要购买一个保险。
世上最大的保险公司也不可能一家保险公司来为你做所有的这个保险，所以他要联合上百家保险公司来共同承担巨大的风险。
可能也是有史以来所有博物馆最高的，因为没有一个博物馆可以借这么多重要文物一起个给另外一个博物馆。
With the big day now approaching, all departments in the Hong Kong Palace Museum are now in top gear, working hard to finish the big project.
这个是最后准备工作，我们现在看好没有问题，就马上可以印，然后全部东西文字都可以上墙了。
包都已经基本上差不多了，但还要最后的这个细节啊，灯光啊，这个效果啊，音量啊，都得在最后调试阶段。然后抓的比较紧的就是我们这九大展厅。
这个屏幕上可以多给它一点光啊，是
不是？
对。
所有的展览到最后都成为关键。
光线应该可以调吧，我看一看，
这一边亮一边暗的，这怎么行
啊？没有任何事情是小的，你说你这小数点你写错了，东西放不进去，展柜设计错了，大小设计错了，放不进去。
这是湿度和温度吗？
湿度还有这个UV 的这个强度啊，然后还有这个 VOC， 就是里面空气质量。对对。
就是最后准备的阶段，那个文物快来了嘛，所以我们就最后的准备了，都一定要，然后也要确保这个 showcase 是好的状态啊，完美的，然后清洁都要做好这样。
我真的有一天就查了一下我的电话，做那个记录，我走了大概18000步，
就在
这里。
On May 27th, the museum personnel are waiting for scholars and experts from Beijing. Because of the pandemic, their visit has been rescheduled several times. Finally, however, it will now go ahead. The Beijing experts will arrive tomorrow.
开馆准备工作都差不多了，现在关键就是北京博物院这个文物运到香港。这个是一个非常非常大的工程。
我们来
这个新馆，从时间，从人员，从文物啊，任何的方面，任何的细节都特殊，所以就会特别困难。一个很简单的事情，可能这要难100倍。
那你们今天呢，赶快把展柜搞干净，里面各种各样的威力，我们明天就开始布展了。
2656，海关他们刚检查过了我们的箱子。
今次最后呢，有个机关。
好，
司機喺邊度？
喂，比 schedule 應該早咗，依家咧就開始上課噶啦。大概15分鐘到啦。OK， 唔該曬。
The other thing we asked that Huaxie people will hold the bag and the sides when you guys handle it.
Yeah.
Three people.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
这个酒吧周建文物到我们香港故宫以后，要在一个月以内把它完成做好，放在展柜里头，然后把整个展览做好以后开放，也是一个非常非常大的工程。
香港故宫文化博物馆咧，其实对于香港本土，尤其是香港嘅年轻人咧，其实都好重要嘅一个角色喺度。将来佢哋会嚟到呢度，我哋有个导赏团俾佢哋啲学生。
Through the cultural relics, the two palace museums are now linked together.
可以说我们是不是一家人，胜似一家人。但是它是独立的，啊，它是独立的一个法人机构，不是故宫博物院的一个香港分馆，啊，但是它主要的文物的展陈是来自于故宫博物院。但是我们希望呢，就是将来，就是相互的这样的支持。
Now it's time to place the relics in their cases.
北京故宫的文物分五次运到香港，还有一批文物是昨天到了。现在今天我们这个团队已经开始把文物放进去。
24箱开了，16箱，厉害厉害厉害！明天搞完，明天搞完，明天搞完。
这些文物非常非常重要，所以呢，对我们来讲就是真的是有一个很强的一个这个责任感吧。
这次来的文物不仅数量多，种类丰富，啊，等级高，名品汇集，就是名作汇集，有很多很多的叫故宫的明星产品。
Gallery 3, themed Clay to Treasure, exhibits ceramics from the Palace Museum.
对，这个肯定是，这个肯定是。然后那个
是清仿的，
所以它那个
是布展组嘛，所以主要是目前来讲，我们这次来布展的任务，首先是把所有的文物要在这边做一个开箱和点胶。实际上我们那个序厅放了12个非常非常漂亮的菊花型的盘子，它还专门定制了一个弧形的展柜，去给这个展品一个非常好的呈现方式。汝窑呢，实际上它是在现在我们的这个眼光里面，它是非常非常珍贵的。它取自那个一个诗句，就是"雨过天晴云破处"，下雨了之后天气刚刚放晴的那种，不是非常的蓝，是那种透透的蓝色。那么这样的一个以小孩的形象做成一个枕头，它实际上是非常的生动和活泼的。
Gallery 9.Features horses, which have special significance in Hong Kong culture.
我叫达维嘉，我来自故宫博物院器物部。这次挑选的这个6个马首，汉代的马首里面，就有4个，我们觉得应该是汉武帝得到汗血宝马以后的这个陶俑做成的那个马的样子。这件作品叫《铜镀金骑士牵马钟》，挺有意思的。它是修复过的，它旁边有一根绳子，是作为它的这个发条，它是可以走的，而且是旁边的那个小窗梁的那个飞龙什么的都是可以动的。
Treasures embodying imperial culture during the Qing Dynasty have now been carried to the gallery.
我叫王燕。然后我是来自于故宫的宫廷部，就是头上的那个天花也是感觉像我们那个宫殿的黄琉璃瓦一样， 所以其实是有一种熟悉的感觉在里面，配合我们宫廷的这些故宫的文物嘛，给他们又注入了一种新的活力吧。
What is the lifespan of a piece of paper? Chinese people have the concept of 1,000-year-old paper. That indeed is probably the longest paper can last. In Gallery 8, which houses calligraphy, curators are getting ready to take their own special delivery.
Hey, 王老师。
哎，
王老师，又打扰您。大规模的那个书现在有一个预期的时间吗？
就是这个是感应的。
嗯。
那么后续的它印刷的一个时间恐怕，恐怕要有半个月的时间。
那这次其实就是濒危的都能够到是吗？因为我们之前有点担心说
要晚一些，
但是会来。
但是现在也是这个时间，因为文物局那边就是整个那个濒危的这个手续时间已经在缩短了。
好，那谢谢您，那到时候我们香港见。期待您过来。
好，
谢谢。拜拜。
再见。
More than 70 years ago, a batch of paintings and calligraphy works were acquired in Hong Kong and returned to the Forbidden City in Beijing. Now, another batch of fine paintings and calligraphy will come from Beijing to be exhibited in Hong Kong. After the exhibition, these national treasures will be returned to be stored without being displayed.
比方说我们希望文物能够更多的汇集子孙后代，能够让它延年益寿，就不是我们的文物无限期的在外展览，所以我们制定了文物的休眠这样的制度。我们尤其像这个有机质的书画呀，这个服饰就是丝织的哈，这些我们定期是要有休眠的。
With the transportation of 5 batches of relics now being arranged, experts in both Hong Kong and Beijing are working flat out. Curator Chun Li An is in regular communication with her colleague Yang Shu, who often travels to Beijing to discuss the progress of the work.
Yang Shu, 你最近北京点胶怎样了？
点胶现在已经是应该是过半了，第三批已经点完了，给你看看我们这边是故宫角楼，然后那边能看到景深，还能看到景深，对吧？今天天气特别好。第三部分呀，那个多媒体，我看建筑部分都已经差不多了，但就是还有就是在那个寿皇殿月台上的月悬那部分。我们还要给他们画个图，告诉他们那个月悬应该放哪里。
我作为香港故宫文化博物馆的代表和故宫老师，两方面来对文物的商况进行一个确认。那这次故宫点胶的正式开始是在5月6日，可能前后需要经过一个半月的时间。那北京故宫这边呢，我感觉到最大的不同就是北京故宫的老师对文物本身的认识，对文物的熟悉的程度，是我们无法企及的。
这个印呢，叫宫殿印，它是非常之重要，就是它是一个乾隆皇帝对儒家经典的非常重视，一个这个物证。
There is less than a month to go now before the museum opens.
我最近看到展厅，进度非常好，很多文物已经放进柜里头，已经封起来了。我非常非常兴奋的啊，古董文物终于在我们展厅里头布置好了。
行政长官今日嚟咧，就博物馆起晒之后咧，竣工之后佢第一次真系嚟睇。
这件是很有名的，然后也是一个明星产品。
对啊，
但它特别之处在什么呢？就是我们在这个时代看到的定窑的产品，大多数都是碗啊、盘啊、瓶啊，一些日常生活中使用的。像这种呢，把它做成了一个像雕塑形状的呢，是非常非常少见的。
这个是我们就是第一批来的，因为我们这个马仔文物是从汉代开始的，然后我们选取了这几个汉代的马头。
它不是一个单单一个展示的这个地方，还是一个教育的地方，可以让香港的市民多了解这中华的文化。香港故宫文化博物馆 还带了一个很重要的元素，我当时没有想过，就是他这个感动了很多的私人的收藏家愿意捐赠，藏品非常丰富，价值非常高。
他们知道我们整个馆这个定位这个愿景，支持我们就是怎么样去传承中华文化。
Gallery 6 of the Hong Kong Palace Museum now houses items donated by local collectors. In years to come, it is hoped that more such individuals in the city will follow suit and donate precious items they have acquired to the museum. July the 2nd, 2022 is the official opening day of the Hong Kong Palace Museum. After so much work by staff in both Beijing and Hong Kong, the newest major museum in China is now ready to receive visitors.
一个展览呢，是需要透过非常非常多的人的合作才能够做起来的。
我们来自不同的背景，我们重新看这些传统的文物的时候，可以有怎么样一个新的解读？
已经是经过两年的磨合，其实即系而家我觉得是一个相当顺畅的地步。
建立一个故宫，展出故宫的文物，其实对于香港亦都是一个很有意义的事情。
咁畢竟我哋每個都係中國人，咁我哋可以睇到親身地近距離接觸到啲作品咧，其實係我覺得一個好大嘅榮幸。
不只是來看到國寶，而是能夠通過這些作品，能夠了解到這些古代的文人怎麼來通過這些繪畫來表達他們的感情。
一生當中能見證這樣一個新的故宮的建立，是很有意義的。
I mean, it's an opportunity for treasures which are normally in Beijing.To come to Hong Kong and to be accessible to Hong Kong public.
The Hong Kong Palace Museum is truly the greatest gift to Hong Kong.
我相信，所以我看见。
这是一个将来要办成世界一流的博物馆。
所以香港其实它也应该发挥一个优势，就是它要把这个世界上最好的一些博物馆的做法都要带到这个博物馆来。
当我们去向社会向世界展示故宫它的文化价值的时候，一定是一个完整的、全面的一个呈现。它是如何体现了中华五千年文明的生生不息？
你只有知道你从哪里来，才能知道去哪里，啊，走向哪里。所以还有一个这样的展览，这些展览呢，就是从不同的角度啊，你去理解中华优秀传统文化，
连接古代跟现代。连接北京跟香港，连接世界。
The treasures have finally arrived and are now on display at the new museum. Amid the bustle of Asia's world city, this is a quiet corner, a world of artifacts, colors, and images. Encountering them and the installations that complement them will bring us closer to the soul of China.Elegant and intriguing. They have been waiting for us for centuries.